Hello and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to add widgets to your footer. There's many ways that you can do this. I'm going to show you how to do this strictly in the widgets area. So first we're going to go to appearance and then widgets. So it's important to note that WordPress is originally blog software. Obviously, people use it to create full big websites, whether it's, you know, e-commerce or just informational or whatever the case may be. But these widgets that you see here in this available widgets area, most of these are specific to a blog. And because we have WooCommerce installed, we have widgets that are specific to WooCommerce. But there are a lot of widgets that can be used, whether you have a sidebar for your blog or just in like your footer or your header areas. So I've used a plugin that I've installed called Black Studio Tiny MCE. And what this does is it allows for a visual editor to be added to your widget areas. So that's what this is. But if you do not want to use a visual editor and you just kind of want to see what the other widgets available can, you know, allow you to do, just know like there's, you know, widgets like an image that will display an image. You can use like recent posts. That's pretty popular in the footer area. You can also set up a text widget. There's just many different widgets that you can use, but I'll show you what this visual editor one can do. So you can either click and check off the widget area you want to add this particular widget to. And so we're going to do that. But also, I'm just going to close that. But also you can drag and drop these into the area you want them to be in. So just know that as well. So I'm just going to remove it, I can just throw it over to the left and it's gone. So we're just going to focus on this particular one. So for this visual editor widget, which again is powered by the Black Studio Tiny MCE widget, this allows me to just pretty much have free reign, you know, on whatever I want to add here. I can add media. I can, you know, type in text. It doesn't have to be one specific thing. This allows you to do a lot. So I'm going to uncheck this automatically add paragraphs because I'm not going to add text in this area, but I am going to add an image. So I'm just going to click add media. I'm going to select this logo right here. I'm going to keep it to medium since it is kind of a large image, as you can see, and I'm just going to insert it into the post. But in this case, of course, it's a widget. So that's pretty much all that I want for this particular one. So I'm just going to hit save. And now I'm going to just close that. I'm going to use a different widget. I'm going to use text and I'm going to put it in this particular area. So for this is kind of like that visual editor that you see here. It's just a more condensed version because this is specific to text and, you know, things like that. This is more if you just want to do a lot of things and you just want like that freedom that you get when you're editing like a page or a post. So that's pretty much all that is. So for this, I'm just gonna type some text. All right, and so just bold it and we'll italicize it as well. So I'll go ahead and hit save and that's it. So now we're gonna check our site. And as you can see, it has added two of my widgets right here. So this one on the left and then this one on the right. So it's important to note that different themes, different things. Some themes might allow you to select the footer layout and you'll have more footer areas to add widgets to. It really just depends on your theme options. This tutorial focuses on the 2020 theme, which is a free theme through WordPress.org. So that's pretty much it. Another way that you can customize your widgets is by going to customize under appearance. So just show you what that looks like. All right, so once we're in this screen, we can go to widgets and then we can select the widget area, and we can add a widget if we want to, and it gives us this list of available widgets. We can also search through them if we don't want to scroll. And that's pretty much it. But if I didn't want to do that, I can just expand this and, you know, edit as needed. And again, that shows right here, which it's kind of hidden. Say I didn't want this anymore, I can just remove it. And as you can see, it just moved that over. So I can, you know, add a different one in here if I wanted to. I can just do an image, and then I can just add my image directly, and we'll set that to none. All right. And then as you can see, it adds it back. So, and then I can hit publish and I'm all set. So I can click this back button to get back to the widgets area, and then I can focus on this one and I can expand it. I can add more text if I want to. All right, so that's what it would look like if I wanted to, you know, type out a bunch of text. And again, I can just hit publish and it's all set. So I'm just going to hit back on this and back on this, and then I can just X out and it'll take me back to the dashboard. So that concludes our tutorial. If you're looking for more tutorials like this, you can search through our support center. We have a lot of different articles on WordPress and how to set up certain things. Also, if you have questions about setting up certain things, such as like your footer, and you just need some quick help, you can always reach out to our support department. They are available 24/7, and they can be reached by phone, by email, or by live chat. Thank you very much.